watched a clip from the beer pong championship and she thinks it's so easy she can do it better than them. She throws her phone away in frustration.
Later that night,
she plays with her friend Jacob and her friend makes the shot. And now it's her turn and she channels her inner kung fu to throw the ultimate shot. Mia totally misses the cup and hits the head of her friend instead. And so she asks her classmates taking the Six Sigma class to apply the DMAIC methodology to see how we can increase the odds of throwing a ping pong ball into the cup. So first, to define a problem, we drew up a process map to see the flow of how the beer pong game works. So once we're able to map out how the beer pong game works, we go into the measure phase, where we begin our experimental setup to find the best and optimal method to throw the ping pong ball into the cup. We run experiments with 3 operators, 10 measurements, and 3 repeats. And for our measuring system, we measure where the ball lands in relation to the cup. If the ball hits the cup, the distance is 0 because the ball hits the cup successfully. But if the ball hits outside the cup, we label the part where the ball lands beyond the cup as positive, and if the ball lands behind the cup as negative in distance. The distance here is centimeters. We perform a gauge R&R analysis on our measuring system. The gauge R&R percentage contribution is higher than 30%, thus it is not the most ideal. The problems must be identified to remove root cause in order to improve the measurement system. The reason that repeatability contributes majorly to the variation is because the chances of throwing a ping pong ball and making it into the cup by an operator varies from round to round. At the same time, the difference of in parts and measurement spans by small margins measured in centimeters. This contributes to the high gauge R&R, with repeatability being a major contributor. And look at the R chart by operator. All points are well within the control limits. However, all points are within the control limits for the X bar chart as well. This indicates all operators show a higher part-to-part variation. For distance by part and operator plots, both part and operator have the same pattern, which means that there is no operator interaction and bias. Hence, as a whole, this calls for a more precise and more controlled measuring system to be used in the future if the project is conducted again. Next, we perform a process capability analysis before improvement. The CPK is 1.31, which is less than 2. This indicates that further improvement could be made to increase the likelihood of throwing a ping pong ball into the cup. But overall, it is still acceptable, as it is normally distributed. The reason for the gap in the histogram around the center between 0 and 3.4 is because 0 is recorded when the ball lands into the cup, and 3.4 is the radius of the cup, the distance recorded if the ball hits the edge of the cup. It's hard to measure precisely between 0 and 3.4 with our current measuring setup, so this explains a gap between 0 and 3.4 in the histogram shown. And to perform analysis on this experiment, we begin by constructing a fishbone diagram to analyze the cause and effect factors that would cause a player to miss throwing the ball into the cup. We identify the major factors such as posture of throw, throwing technique, environmental factors, ping pong ball weight and quality, cup height, size and distance from thrower, and operator experience and physiological factors. So our objective is to increase the likelihood of throwing the ping pong ball into the cup. Our Y is hit or miss the cup, and X are throwing techniques and positions and factors that go into the throw, such as cup, ping pong ball, and environmental factors. However, there are some of the factors that we did not consider, such as drunkenness, interference, and environmental factors, as they are hard to measure and beyond the scope for this project. And the throwing techniques and positions we tested are the overarm throw while facing forward, the underarm throw while facing forward, and we have also tested a combination of high and low throwing height position, as well as high and low cup height from the surface of the table. We constructed a Pareto chart, with A being the cup height, B is the throwing technique of underarm slash overarm, and C is the throwing height. From the Pareto chart, we see that the underarm and overarm throwing technique, as well as the throwing height, are the main effects, and the interactions are statistically significant as indicated by the elements crossing the red line. From the main effects plot, we see that the throwing technique of underarm or overarm and throwing height are major factors. We see that if the throw is underarm, there is a higher likelihood of the ball landing closer to the cup, and if the throwing height is a little bit higher, then there's also a higher likelihood of the ball making it into the cup. Looking at the interaction plot for distance, we see that non-parallelism indicates an interaction, and this chart indicates that the either two of the X in this experiment have interactions. And the interaction between the posture throwing technique of underarm or overarm and height is significant. And looking at the residual plots, we see that the normal probability plot appears normal, and for the versus fits, it does not have a specific pattern in either direction, and for versus order, all points are well within the control limit. As a conclusion, the residuals are normally distributed with a mean of 0 with a constant variance. After identifying and analyzing the different factors in the improvement phase, we can identify that the underarm throw forward facing was the best technique to throw the ping pong ball into the cup. We infer that the underarm throwing technique facing the cup gives the player the most stability, control, and consistency in his or her throw. With this, and conducted a process capability analysis for the improved throwing technique, we see that the CPK is 2.13, with the peak of the histogram around the mean with a normal distribution. With the CPK above 2, this indicates that the technique meets the Six Sigma process standard and is an improvement over the throwing techniques used by the operators at the beginning. So there you have it. The next time you play a game of beer pong with your friends or colleagues at an after-work event, remember to use the underarm technique while facing forward so that you can win this game at the most critical moment and impress your friends and colleagues in the future, and you will be the most popular person in the event.